Friends and family, we are assembled here today in the presence of God to unite Thomas, Paul, Betterly, and Brandy, Jodina, piano Turner, in marriage. The Bible teaches us that marriage is to be a permanent relationship of one man and one woman, freely and totally committed to each other as companions for life. The Bible also reveals to us God's sovereign role in bringing the first couple together, and we see that in Scripture in Genesis 2. God's still in the business, we're going to find out, right? But back in Genesis 2, we see in Genesis 2:18 that the Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone." That says a lot, Thomas. He said, "I will make him a helper fit for him." So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and while he slept, took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Thomas and Brandy, I believe in the same way that God demonstrated his sovereignty in not only providing but bringing Eve to Adam, that he's done the very same thing for both of you today in your lives. Thomas, God knew that it wasn't good for you to be alone. And he knew what you needed in your life and who you needed in your life, and he knew when you needed her. So he provided Brandy just for you. And he brought you two together. And I might add at this point that God ordains the means as well as the ends. What that means is God did it personally in Genesis 2. But in his sovereignty, he works circumstances and he uses others. And from talking with a few of your friends, it sounds like that God used some of them to help bring you two together as well. To give a little push, I guess, on that first ask. Brandy, he's done the same thing for you. He brought you, Thomas, to provide, to protect, and to demonstrate servant leadership, and to love you as Christ loves the church. I'm going to ask at this time if you will face each other. And Thomas, I'm going to ask if you will simply repeat after me as you state these vows to your bride. I, Thomas, take you, Brandy.
I, Thomas, take you, Brandy.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
And my love from this day forward.
And my love from this day forward.
In the presence of God, our family and friends.
In the presence of God, our family and friends.
I offer you my solemn vow.
I offer you my solemn vow.
To be your faithful partner.
To be your faithful partner.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
until death shall part us.
Until death do us part.
Thomas, do you so promise?
I do.
Brandy, do you so promise?
I do.
Thomas, I'm going to ask that you will give this ring and place it on Brandy's left ring finger. Brandy, and to you, as you place this on his ring finger, let this ring be a constant reminder of not only your unending love, but today, the vow that you're taking, the commitment that you're taking, and let the unending circle be a representation of your unending love that you have for Thomas. Place that on his ring finger. At this point, we will do the unity sand as kind of a symbol of the two lives that were separate, and as we come together today, let it represent the unity that will be finalized in just a few moments. So at this point, you can do the unity sand. Congregation, since they have made these vows before God and this assembly, on the authority of God and the laws of this state, I declare that Thomas and Brandy are husband and wife. Thomas and Brandy, you are no longer two, as the scripture says, but God has called you to be one. And the scripture says, what God therefore has joined together, let no man separate. Thomas, you may kiss your bride. Place them. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Thomas Betterly.